Hey there, everyone. Welcome to another PIVX class. Today, we're going to cover a simple yet often mistaken topic. We're going to talk about how cryptocurrency coins are different from tokens. They are both run on blockchain technology, and they are both traded quite similarly, but they are actually quite different. So let's just cut to the chase and get started. To begin with, let's recap our knowledge on blockchain technology. The blockchain is like a digital ledger. Each block is a period of time where transactions occur. Entries are recorded by all the people who possess the blockchain. When the time comes and a block is finalized, the transactions are locked in. Then the next block begins building on top of the previous one, plus all the others that came before it. Users of the specific cryptocurrency don't actually hold their coins or tokens. They hold the keys that allow them to make an entry on the blockchain that states the coins or tokens are being sent somewhere else out of their control. This is how the blockchains that power cryptocurrencies work. An interesting thing about blockchains is that just about any information can be recorded on them, not just the currency that it is associated with. This allows even for the ownership of objects or resources to be recorded on the blockchain. And this is where the difference begins. If we step back a bit and look at what a cryptocurrency coin is, the difference gets pretty obvious. To begin with, coins run on their own blockchain. Many are alterations of the Bitcoin blockchain, many others are completely unique, but they are all completely self-sufficient. Additionally, their value is derived solely from their existence. They are a currency meant to be used to facilitate payments. Ultimately, they are worth something because people have decided that they are worth something. Cryptocurrencies like Ethereum are considered coins, but you are unlikely to see Ether widely accepted as currency for purchasing goods. Ether is meant to be the currency of the Ethereum network. This network allows other cryptocurrency projects to operate on top of it. Creating and maintaining your own blockchain can be quite difficult for smaller projects with more niche purposes. Instead, many operate on top of the Ethereum network, and users of their currency have to pay small fees in Ether. In short, Ether is a coin because it runs on its own blockchain and only gains value simply through its existence. It is not pegged to any other thing. People want it, people want to use it, therefore it has value. Those cryptocurrencies that run on the Ethereum network are not coins. They are tokens. Not operating on your own blockchain is enough to be considered a token in the wider crypto community. Additionally, though, I want to talk about what's the advantage in a token. Many of these projects running on the Ethereum network gain value from their specific purpose. This goes beyond the intrinsic value that coins rely on. Many token cryptocurrencies are actually backed by something. When you trade a token, you are also trading what is backing that token. There is a wide range of what this can be, so we'll just go over a couple examples to get your head around what tokens can do. Since you can record ownership of anything on the blockchain, you can make a token for the trade of anything. One use case would be the tokenization of gold. A company could buy 1,000 ounces of gold and create 1,000 gold bucks. They could then sell those gold bucks to people for the price they choose, probably similar to what an ounce of gold would cost, with the guarantee that one gold buck is worth 1 ounce of gold. A person would only need to trade them a gold buck to get an ounce of gold back. This allows for people to effectively trade gold around instantly without having to physically move the gold. Then any person that wants to physically claim the gold can by just turning in the token. All transactions with this token would have their fees paid for with Ether and not the token itself. Tokens don't necessarily have to be backed by something physical, though. They can simply be the currency for a specific service or purpose. This can be a lot of things. For instance, you could have a site where there's a token that gives you the ability to listen to music, kind of like an alternative to Spotify. Instead of paying a monthly fee for access to an entire library of stuff you maybe like, you could instead buy a bunch of these tokens and cash them in to listen to your favorite songs, like quarters on a jukebox. This has two benefits. One, you are not paying for things you don't care about. And two, musicians can more directly benefit from sales. You probably won't buy dinner with these music tokens, but you can support your favorite musicians at a fair price. These are just a couple examples of tokens. There are a lot of use cases for crypto out there that almost no one could have imagined. And I am sure there is a lot more that people have yet to imagine. Also, to be clear, the Ethereum network is not the only one that tokens utilize. There are several cryptocurrency projects that operate networks similar to the Ethereum network. Like any market, there is a lot of competition. Now, before we wrap this up, let's recap the difference. Primarily, coins run on their own blockchain. But secondarily, their value is almost always intrinsic, meaning their value is dependent on people's belief in that currency. The primary decider for what tokens are is that they run on top of a blockchain that they don't control. Additionally, many derive value from their use case. This can be access to specific services, the trade of certain resources, or many other unforeseen opportunities. That's it for today. In the coming months, we'll be remaking the PIVX Basics course. That's the primer course that we did when the channel first began. The channel has really developed a lot since the original course, so I think it is time we remade it. Keep an eye out for it. We're really going to need your help to promote it and put it in the laps of new users. On that note, please leave the video a like and share it with someone new to crypto. Thank you for tuning in. I love having you here, and I will see you in the next PIVX class.